Wearing that Yankee cap. I like it.
Always.
Wearing that Yankee cap with pride right now.
I once wore it to the Emmys in 2001.
Now, come on now. What do you mean?
Well, I was nominated. I had won the year before.
For the West Wing.
For the West Wing. And pretty sure I wasn't going to win again. And I had tickets in Phoenix. That, you know, the World Series and the Emmys coincided because of the delay because of 9/11.
Right.
And I had tickets to Game 6 and 7 in Phoenix for the World Series against the Diamondbacks. The Yankees took the three greatest games ever played in the World Series in New York. I was working, so I couldn't go to that.
That was Jeter's Mr. November moment.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
And Brocious hit one out, too, I think in the ninth inning. And we got blown away. Pettit, remember, was tipping pitches, it turned out, revealed later in Sports Illustrated. We lost 16-3 in Game 6. And I had tickets to Game 7, which was the night of the Emmys. So I told the producers of the West Wing, I'm going to Game 7. I'm not going to go to the Emmys.
Mm-hmm.
And they said, okay. And then they gave me a 6 a.m. call time on Monday. And we had driven to Phoenix. So I wasn't going to make it back on time because it's a 12-hour drive.
They showed you.
So I went to the Emmys and showed up in a Yankee hat with the Stars and Stripes in the NY.
Right. I remember that.
And that's what I wore. And we were sitting with the Soprano people who were all Yankee fans. So during the game, we made the stage manager, who was wearing a Yankee hat, turn on the game during the commercials. So I got to see Soriano's home run. And then ran backstage after we won Best Show and found a green room and watched Mariano strike out a guy. I didn't know what inning was. I thought the game was over.
It was the eighth inning. I was there behind home plate covering it for ESPN, sitting next to my, at the time, fiance, who was covering, my wife Susie, was covering the game for Fox Sports. And we were sitting there after Rivera struck out the side in the eighth inning, Richard. Fans of the Diamondbacks were crying. They were crying. Even wives, player wives, we were sitting in that area, they were crying. Because they knew the great Mariano had shown up, and it was going to be a foregone conclusion in the ninth, and yet that did not happen.
And yet, by the way, Gonzalez's hit still hasn't left the infield. So it's like, let's be clear, you know, it wasn't tainted win, but they didn't. You know, Tony Womack, of all people, got the only real hit in that inning. And when Mariano missed on the bunt to second base.
Yeah.
And pulled Jeter off. I still think Jeter could have kept his foot on the base.
Look at you.
But remember, the fans in Arizona got really hyped up in the top of the ninth when Randy Johnson came in and was striking out Yankees. And they got really loud. And I remember seeing a shot of Mariano. First time I've ever seen him look worried. And I think he was just exhausted because he was pitching two innings. Who was the setup man in 2001?
Was it Stanton?
No. It was not Stanton.
Nelson?
Mendoza.
Ramiro Mendoza.
Mendoza, who was unhittable in that postseason, and I wanted him to come in the eighth.
You're second-guessing Torrey.
I'm still angry. Pulling in the infield.
Were you alone in that green room, or did some of the Sopranos cast members come with you, too? Or
no, what? I thought I was alone. Mm-hmm. And after Mariano struck out the guy in the eighth inning, I went, and turned around and realized for 4 minutes I was blocking these two people sitting on the couch who said nothing. And it turned out to be Rob Reiner and Mary Tyler Moore. And my first thought was, I grew up watching you guys on Saturday night. I since later worked with Rob and told him the story. Mm-hmm. But I was going to tell Mary Tyler Moore, you were the best thing when I was young. And then I realized I have gray hair and I'm going to make her feel like she's 112.
Right.
So that's rude. And I just walked out. I didn't apologize. I didn't say anything. I just felt so bad.
That's fantastic.
I watched it on watched the horror on some other TV.
Richard Schiff here on the Rich Eisen Show. Are you at all concerned? I mean, Aaron Boone, we didn't discuss this on the show today, but Aaron Boone said he's thinking of dropping Giancarlo Stanton down in the order. He has just been awful ever since he had that two home run game. Obviously, he had one in
first game.
That's a panic move.
Well,
it's April 18th.
No. They look bad. They look bad. And they've looked bad since midway through spring training. I'll turn off my phone.
No problem.
They started out 9-1 in spring training, and then they started coasting along.
Right.
The Red Sox started out mediocre and then started winning everything in spring training, and that's continued into the season. And I wonder about Aaron Boone. Is anyone else?
A lot of people in New York are already.
I would like him to be the manager for the next 15 years.
You would?
Well, if they're playing for the first 15 games like they play.
Are you a Red Sox fan?
He is.
Yes.
All right. Well, you know what?
Yeah.
Stanton's going to be fine, but I don't like three righties in a row, all who would have a similar swing and can be beaten with similar pitches. So a pitcher with a good outside low slider or a splitter. If he gets into a zone pitching against these guys, he can get them all out. I want to see Didi. I want to see Bird come back and break up that three righties in a row. I'm not worried about Stanton in the long run.
I guess that would be the idea about it. It has been a difficult start. And I do wonder, even because I wanted his binder to be thrown off of a cliff, never to be seen again, I do wonder if Girardi would have gotten this team off to a better start. I do think about that.
You have to assume that he would. His preparation was, bar none. I mean, he was very thorough as a manager. I don't see the moves. I don't see the pitching moves being all that different. Right. But the pitchers don't seem ready. Their bullpen was supposed to be the greatest in the history of baseball, has an ERA of about 6. And they're getting killed. And they look bad in the field. There's something about what's happening there. They don't look ready to win. And maybe they're another year away. Who knows?
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.